high-definition TV, high-definition video. And it will also record all the parameters of the car, speed, RPM, G-forces, tire temperature, tire pressure, just an inordinate amount of stuff that goes on in the car. And it's also going to record our voices.
Oh, good.
So,
until later. Yeah.
So whatever you, it's not real clear recording because there's a lot of wind noise when we're out on the track.
Sure.
And so forth, but just to let you know, there's actually a lawsuit that took place because you can put this car in what's called valet mode when you take it to a restaurant or whatever.
Uh-huh.
And when they do that, you put it in valet mode and it'll limit the amount of speed that it can go.
Oh.
Because you don't want a valet, you know,
going
racking
crazy
up your car.
Yeah.
And then you see your wristband. So the guy, the valet took it out, abused the car, had his girlfriend with him. They had a private conversation, came back. The owner found out, showed it to the restaurant owner. The guy gets fired, and then he sues because it's a privacy issue. They didn't tell him that his voice was going to be recorded, and he and his girlfriend had a private conversation. Can you believe that?
Oh, man.
Great litigious society we have.
That sucks.
All right, we're going to get on track. You ready?
Ready.
All right, here we go. Blast off. Set the front wheels.
Yeah.
Saw you and your dad doing it too. We do a little cool down because we want our brake rotors to cool down kind of gradually.
Okay.
Versus if we just come in and park, they get like even hotter because these brake rotors will get up to 1200 or 1400 degrees.
What?
Yeah. It's just astronomically hot. Cherry red hot.
Which makes sense what you have to get. Well, why those aren't stock.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah, it basically melts stock brake pads. So you gotta have brake pads that are capable of handling that kind of heat.
Yeah.
So just over and over and over. You can imagine going from, you know, 150 down to 50 in the next lap around.
And oh, yeah.
Front straight, we're doing 140. Well, when I'm by myself, I'm close to 150 on that straight, too. Down to, you know, 45 or something. So you're scrubbing 100 miles an hour or 110 miles an hour. And those rotors are just, you know, handling that heat over and over and over.
Mm-hmm.
So they get plenty of friction abuse.
So how many times can you do this before you have to get them changed or get new ones?
Good question. So a full set of track brake pads will cost me about $600. And they will last, the front ones will last maybe 4 days, 4 track days.
What?
And the back ones maybe 8 track days. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
If I came out here with stock brake pads, they would not last 1 day.
I can imagine.
And I would have horrible brake fade.
Oh,
even halfway through the day, they wouldn't hold. So part of the expense of this hobby is of course, as instructors, your dad and I don't pay anything for the event. These guys paid $500 or $600 for a 2-day event.
Jeez.
The students did.
Wow.
But part of the expense is obviously gas.
Yeah.
Tire wear.
Yep.
And brake pads. Brake pads are actually more of an expense than tires are. Because they just go through brake pads like crazy. And the rotors themselves.
Uh-huh.
But they actually last longer than the brake pads do.
Okay. How often do you go through... how often do you go through tires, and would you buy used tires, or do you normally buy new tires?
No, buy new tires.
Okay.
And these tires are stock tires, Michelin, Pilot,
wow.
Super Sport. Yeah, best tire I've ever run on the street or track. Unreal good.
Huh.
You can feel how they gripped. We'll hold, and I'll show you the video here in a second. In fact, what I'll do is I'll throw it up on YouTube, and then I'll send you the link so you can have it.
Awesome.
On that, you'll see the G-force that we hold, and in some of these corners we're holding like 1.2 to 1.3 Gs, which means a G-force, of course, is a gravitational pull that's holding us on Earth.
Uh-huh.
That's
yeah.
A G-force. So when you have a lateral G that's 1, it means it's throwing you to the side with the same amount of force that is holding you to the Earth, which means you should be just sliding off the track.
Right? Oh, sure, yeah.
But we're actually holding 20% more G-force laterally than what's holding us on Earth.
Huh.
How we're able to do that is the suspension of the car and the stickiness of these tires.
Oh, okay.
And so we're just stuck to the pavement, you know, literally almost kind of like glued to it. Oh, your dad's...
Mom did that too.
All right, we'll stop.